If you have a disease where most people get sick and it has a high fatality rate, then what you can do is you can find those people, do source control, quarantine them, do contact tracing. But if you have a illness that is mild in a lot of people, so they don't even interrupt their work schedule, they're still going around and doing what they do socially, and there's this whole only the tip of the iceberg is the symptomatic people, then it's going to be extremely difficult to control. All of these coronaviruses originally came from bats. And bats have over 500 different coronaviruses. Only 7 have made the jump to humans. 4 that caused the common cold, SARS and MERS, the Middle Eastern Respiratory Syndrome. And where we believe they're coming from is what we call wet markets in China, where they keep live animals, and basically the feeling is you get some kind of invigoration from the animal, but the closer it is to have been alive, the more you get. And so they keep these animals alive, stacked on top of each other in these wet markets, a perfect way to transmit viruses back and forth between species. And unless they're all closed now in China, and the Chinese government has made a suggestion that they're going to try and outlaw these wet markets. But I don't know if that's going to happen. This is really ingrained in traditional Chinese culture. And so it would be very difficult. But if we don't close these wet markets, we'll see more coronaviruses. And so for SARS, it was from bats to civet cats. And the civet cats were actually kept in the restaurants in Hong Kong until they were ordered. And so the civet cat, it went from the bat to the civet cat to humans. For MERS, it actually went from the bats to camels, and it's the camels that are transmitting it to humans. In this situation, the highest suspect is the pangolin. And pangolins are basically armored anteaters. They're mammals. They are an endangered species, but they were kept in these wet markets. And there's a coronavirus from a pangolin that's a 99% match with this current coronavirus. So that looks likely. The sad thing is that despite the fact it's an endangered species and it's illegal to sell them in China, this is the most trafficked endangered species in the world. The meat is considered a delicacy for rich Chinese, and then the scales are used in traditional Chinese medicine.